passion, love, and care through the power of His Holy Spirit. Amen.
Why do you ask
Princess
from God to ask Apollonia?
Oh my dear silly child, it's not Apollonia but Apollonia. She is the patron saint of my profession, dentistry. That's why I'm asking for her prayers to help me treat with my patients, because I will not be a good patient without God's help and God's grace.
But what has she done that made her the person of your profession?
Her life is actually interesting. Son.
Yes, Mother, I would love to.
It all started with a gracious miracle from God. There lived in Alexandria, during the first half of the 3rd century, a very opulent magistrate of a known name. He married a woman whom he loved devotedly and who loved him fondly in return. The only blot on the happiness of this pair was the fact that they had no children. They addressed earnest and unceasing prayers to Juno, Ceres, Jupiter, all the gods, to grant unto them a son or daughter to inherit their vast wealth, but all without avail.
Darling, I'm home! There you are.
Hi.
Hey. What's wrong?
Are you crying?
Hey, tell me, why are you crying?
Why? What's the matter?
Sorry, Mom.
Something happened?
Mom, to God, I said I'm praying. Can I give you a chance. Three
pious pilgrims arrived in Alexandria and went from house to house asking alms in the name of the Redeemer and the Blessed Virgin, his mother, for they were tired and hungry.
Spare us with your food. We've been in a long journey and nothing more to eat. Have mercy on us, and may thy sweet Jesus touch your heart. What kind of begging are you doing? And who are the gods whose name you ask?
We just need a piece of bread, ma'am. Jesus is our God, the true Savior, who answers His people when in distress.
He loves us so much that He willingly died for our salvation.
With His Father and the power of the Holy Spirit, the Virgin Mary conceived Him.
When in distress, call upon Him with faith, and He will answer you.
Baptize yourself and renew your faith, because He will answer those who believe.
Especially when you intercede your prayers to the Blessed Mary, He always listens.
Then the wife of the magistrate fell on her knees and prayed fervently and passionately to the Holy Virgin. Her request was granted. She gave birth to a child, to whom she gave the name of Apollonia. The child grew into a maiden as lovely and graceful as a flower, and as good and pure as she was beautiful. The family of a Roman magistrate quite naturally conformed to the established religion of the state, but the mother never ceased to talk to her daughter about the wonderful circumstances of her birth, and about Christ and the Holy Virgin to whom she had addressed her prayers. Apollonia drank in all the details, and as she got older, there sprang up in her heart a strong desire to be baptized and become a Christian.
My lovely daughter, you were born because of the greatness and mercy of God.
You are the result of a beautiful image. I pray for you, dear child, that as you grow, your faith grows stronger as well.
Mother, I pray that someday a good baptism shall be done unto me, so that I can be a great daughter to my dear God.
And heaven did not leave her helpless. An angel came to her one day and led her out of Alexandria into the desert to the cell of Leonine, a disciple of Saint Anthony.
Dear daughter of God, go upon thy desert in the cell of Leonine, for he will baptize you in water. And with God's grace, you will be his servant, and he shall be your God.
With love and passion, I will be baptized by Leonine.
Apollonia told him her story and her wish to become a Christian, and Leonin baptized her forthwith.
From Alexandria, Evgamit zealousness and love to be baptized. It is my deepest wish to finally become a daughter of God, the creator of all things great.
Upon the power of God, he hears your wish, and such honor of mine, if I can baptize you in the name of our dear God.
Indeed, we are both grateful.
Follow me in the name of God, and I shall baptize you with this grace, power, love, and mercy. Upon the power vested in me, I shall baptize you in the name of God. In nomine Patri et Filii et Spiritus Sancti.
He was barely through when another angel swooped down from heaven and threw a garment which shone white. Apollonia cried,
"This is Apollonia, the servant of God, heading for Alexandria to preach the love and mercy of Christ.
Comfort, sons and daughters of God. Turn your faith unto Him, for He shall grant your prayers and ease your burdens. Be faithful and trust in His glory, for He never fails. He is love Himself. He will never leave us alone, especially during our darkest hours. Know that He is your God and in goodness and in your pain."
Not before long, complaints concerning her and her actions began to pour in on her father.
But I don't understand, why did he, the Roman magistrate, allow his daughter to break so flagrantly the rules of the Roman Empire?
Everyone must be treated fairly.
Yes, I know, right?
Yeah, this needs to reach the magistrate.
Her father, who was very much disturbed, called Apollonia to constrain her conduct. She defended herself with dignity and fervor and still kept on with her preaching and conversions until her father, beside himself with anger.
Apollonia, I am greatly perturbed by all the complaints I'm hearing from the people. As my daughter, I expect more from you. Why are you doing the other way around?
If those rules as much as I dictate to hinder my faith of God, I will gladly disobey them. For the rules that must be followed are from those of God. For those are obedience from Him will grant as an eternal reward.
What did your mother do to you? You know what? I give up. I'm handing you over to the Roman governor myself. Come here!
Her own father gave her up to the Roman governor to be dealt with as a criminal. The governor ordered for her to be taken into the temple of one of the pagan gods, Serapis, most likely, and bade her to fall on her knees before the statue of the deity and adore it.
Come here. Your Majesty! Your Majesty, I apologize for this intrusion, but I'm here to surrender my daughter. She has been spreading new religion, converting all the crowds.
The Almighty Father, the one true God, and whoever believes in Him shall not be perished and be blessed with eternal life.
You dare to break the law and make your own religion? Bring her to the temple of therapy.
Apollonia flatly refused to comply. She advanced haughtily to the statue, made the sign of the cross, and commanded the demon inside to depart.
Bow down before him, adore him until he forgive you.
In the name of my powerful God, demon, be gone and go back wherever you came from.
There was an awful rumble, a crash, a shriek, and from the broken image, the demon fled, crying.
The Holy Virgin, Apollonia.
A backlash against Christians was building. Christians were persecuted and set upon by mobs. The authorities made no effort to stop the mob or protect the Christians.
Father, my Lord and God, we fall upon His
time of anguish. Forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing.
This proceeding served to send the governor into a fit of violent wrath. At his bidding, the girl was bound to a column, and one by one, her beautiful teeth were all pulled out with a pair of pincers. Then a big fire was kindled, and as Apollonia persisted in her faith, she was flung headlong into the blaze, and there she gave her soul up to God, being borne to heaven by his angels.
You witch! You deserve to be toothless for the senseless words that comes out from your mouth.
Everything I said about God is all good, for He alone is all good. And I know that you don't know what you are doing, but He forgives you.
What are you talking about? Just shut up!
No!
How about now? Will you not say sorry to Serapis?
Who's that creature that you speak of? Only God can forgive me. His mercy alone makes my spirit happy. After this sermon, it will be my greatest satisfaction to see his face. It will be my very last day of my life here on earth.
Very well then, it seems like you made your decision.
Save me from this suffering, my Lord. This day shall be my happiest, for I will finally see you after this agony. I pray for their souls, for they don't know what they are doing. You are the only God who created everything with beauty and love. Forgive me, Lord, as you have forgiven me.
So that's how Apollonia's life ended, my dear son. Even though she was horrendously persecuted, she knows that God is and will always be there by her side no matter what. She was able to surpass everything because of God's grace. So remember this, my child. In every distress, anguish, or anger, or anything that makes you down, know that there will always be a loving God who can always calm your every storm.
I am truly inspired by your mom, by you, and especially by the goodness of our God. I want to be like you.
Do not be like me, but be better than I am. Dentistry will never be easy. It is just like a snow. It may snow too high or too low, but remember that our God will always be there for us. You might experience failures, but that doesn't give you the reason to give up.
Do you have something to say?
So
today is our last day. How are you feeling?
I'm good.
So where are we going?
To all the viewers out there, I'd like to apologize sincerely for my misbehaviors, for my tardiness, and my misconduct. I greatly am concerned by my actions.
Again?
Father, Holy Spirit.
With
his father!
With his father! Holy Spirit!
Father!
Action!
This is Apollonia!
Okay.
He will never leave us from the darkest
day. Go!
Yes, I know, right?
Action!
You dare to break the law and make your own religion? Bring her to the Temple of Serapis!
Action!
You dare to break the law and make your own religion?
How about now? Let's say sorry to Erebus.
Therapy!
Everything I said about my God.
Interview one of our actors. Hey Vince, how's the shooting so far?
So far we got we're already finished, but we're going to be at the other part.
Okay. Do you think this movie is gonna be great?
Oh yeah, it's gonna be great. So okay. Check it out, guys. Okay. So
when can the audience watch this movie?
Maybe this finals after after we pass it to our teacher. So
yeah, good.
One, two, three, go!
Swish, swish, swish.